Welcome to Optical Fiber Communication Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you vapor phase axial deposition fiber fabrication method in this session. And to understand vapor phase axial deposition fiber fabrication method, these are my session outlines, where first I'll explain you basics of VAD, vapor phase axial deposition method. Then we will see how this method is there, and at the end I'll explain you advantages of VAD method. And you can see my previous video where I have already explained OVPO, outside phase vapor oxidation method. So there are few advantages which is there with vapor phase axial deposition method. So those advantages that I'll explain you at the end of this session. So let us begin this session with basics of VAD method. Now see, when we talk about VAD, it is vapor phase axial deposition method, which we use it to generate optical fiber. And this method is very similar to OVPO method. So you can see my previous video where I have explained OVPO method. This method is having less pollution during fiber fabrication compared to OVPO method. So in OVPO method, we have outside vapor phase oxidation, while over here in vapor phase axial deposition method, we don't have outside vapor phase oxidation. Here we have gaseous form of particle initially, and that we use it to form optical fiber with less pollution, that we will see in working, so it will be more clear. See, this method does not need mandrel as it is required in OVPO method. In previous video, I have explained OVPO method, where you can see mandrel is used, and because of mandrel, there was a hole in fiber before we have fiber drawing process. So here we don't need that removal of mandrel as it is not there in this method. So this is one advantage which we have it in vapor phase axial deposition method. So let us try to understand how this vapor phase axial deposition method is there. Now one can see this is what the complete structure which is there with vapor phase axial deposition method, where here from torch we insert glass particle, you can see, and this glass particle that is going inside, and here we have reaction chamber, and to analyze internal process of this fiber fabrication, we can have TV connection over here, as well as we can have thermometer connection, thermo viewer connection over here. So that is to have analyze internal process, and here we have exhaust. So porous preform that we insert as a glass particle, right? And after that we pass it through ring heater, and then we pass that optical fiber in seed rod, you can see, right? So that is how complete machine is there. Now let us try to understand how this machine functions. So as I have told, porous preform is formed in that reaction chamber, and this reaction chamber that is inserting this porous preform in this reaction chamber, and where this fiber is getting drawn in vertical upward direction. So this fiber is moving in vertical upward direction, and process is happening in this reaction chamber, where glass particle is there in porous, in form of porous preform inside. This rod that is continuously moving upward, and it is continuously getting rotated. So the rod which we have from this porous preform, which is what optical fiber technically, and that we rotate it continuously and we move it upward so that we can have cylindrical symmetricity of that optical fiber. So we rotate that rod continuously before we draw it into drawing process of optical fiber. As preform moves upward, you can find it will be converted into solid version of that optical fiber by having heating operation. So here we have a ring heater, and by having this ring heater, we heat that optical fiber and we convert that into solid form, right? And resultant preform that can be drawn into optical fiber by further heating into another furnace. So complete process that I have explained, this is just a method of setting preform of optical fiber. So preform generation, that we do it by having vapor phase axial deposition method, where here we have glass particle as a porous preform, and for to analyze complete process, we have TV connection as well as thermo viewer inside, and this is what we are passing it through this rod, and this rod, that is what we are continuously rotating to have symmetrical cylindrical dimensions of optical fiber, and then we pass it through ring inter so that we can transform this porous preform into solid one, and further heating can be done to draw optical fiber, right? So this is how vapor phase axial deposition method is there, and there are a few advantages which is there with VAD method. One is both stab index and graded index fiber that we can make by having this method. This preform has no central hole as it is there in OVPO method. In OVPO method, we use mandrel. That's why there is central hole. But here in VAD, we don't have any central hole as we don't use mandrel. And preform can be used to fabricate continuous length of fiber. So here, this is biggest advantage, which is there with VAD method, where here we use this preform to generate continuous length of fiber. So for long length of optical fiber, we use this VAD method, and it gives very less pollution during fabrication. You can see entire thing is happening inside chamber. So there is no pollution which is happening outside, where initially we have seen OVPO method, where that shoot sintering and shoot deposition, that we do it outside. So there were some pollution which was happening during burning process of shoot deposition, and that is not happening in this case of VAD method. So very less pollution that happens during this fabrication method. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll make videos which will solve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.